I appreciate you, and I love you. I do desire your prayers today. I'll go ahead and give you homework. Marcy sent me a scripture earlier this week, and if you get a chance to read the 37th chapter of Psalm, it's just wonderful. That one verse in there, I'll just go ahead and quote it, read this. I have been young and now I'm old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. He is ever merciful and lendeth, and his seed is blessed. Amen. Amen to that. How gracious God is. And I appreciate the scriptures, but we're going to read here in this first part of this chapter, really the first several verses all the way down through the 12th verse is just a great blessing to us, and has been magnified in our heart. And if you read this very first verse in the second chapter, he's saying, "Wherefore, laying aside all malice and guile and hypocrisies and envies and all evil speaking," and he goes on and he talks about his newborn babes desire the sincere milk of the word, that they may grow thereby. If so be ye have tasted, the Lord is gracious. Amen. 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 I've preached several times out of that. I'm glad I've tasted that, aren't you? But this Bible, precept upon precept. I've heard that as a child. But if you get a chance to read the first chapter in this, it links to the second chapter, and these verses that I just read will link on down to the verses that is on my heart today. But we're going to read just a few verses here, starting at the ninth verse of the second chapter of First Peter. It says, "But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light, which in time past were not a people, but are now the people of God, which had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy." How wonderful that scripture is. We're going to pray. Dear Lord, we come before you again this morning, and I'm glad, Lord, that you haven't turned us away. I'm so thankful, dear Jesus, Lord, that you said to ask and you shall receive. You offered that invitation to us, dear God, and we ask for wisdom this morning. We ask for guidance. We pray, Lord, that you bless this hour, this service, dear Jesus, Lord, that you'd guide each and every one, dear God, as we want to follow you today. But Lord, give us understanding and wisdom of your word, dear Jesus, and I'm so thankful, dear God, that you've given us this scripture, dear Jesus, that you've put a vision in our heart, and we pray, dear Jesus, that you would give us direction today, and you'd put this message in order the way you see fit. We can't do anything without you, dear God. But Lord, you have called us to a better way. And I'm so thankful by your grace, dear Jesus, Lord, that you have touched our hearts. Help us to see today. Help us to know. And I pray, Lord, that your word would be preached in power for your honor and your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. How wonderful it is to read this scripture. And I get blessed, and you know, over the last several weeks, seems like ever since I've come to this church, the Lord has just touched my heart and blessed my heart, and I'm thankful for His grace and His mercy today, and I'm thankful for this scripture that He is able to encourage us and help us, and I'm going to kind of go a little bit backwards. I'm going to read this 10th verse, and then we'll back up and read the scripture that's on our heart. It says, "Which in times past were not a people, but are now the people of God, which had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy." And he'd already clarified this and what he's talking about here. He says, but you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should shew forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen, amen. He's called us out of darkness. He's called us out of what the ways of this world, to quit walking after the ways of this flesh, walking according to the course of this world. But he's called us into his marvelous light, right? That we can see now, that we can know we're not walking in darkness. We don't have to stumble along. We know this path that he has us on, and this path takes us all the way to glory. And what a blessing that it is that he can open our eyes, that he can let us see, that he can show us that this is it's a good way, isn't it? It's a righteous way. It's a holy way. And I'm thankful for his mercy and his grace. There's things and places that you can go and things that you can see, and you can just tell sometimes things aren't just right. People's minds aren't on what they need to be, whether it's in drunkenness or the drugs of this world or the filth of this world. We just know that isn't right, and it isn't pure in our heart. It isn't pure in our lives. Oh, but God's way is not that way, is it? He doesn't lead you into darkness. Listen, he leads us in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. His way is righteous. It's holy. It's good. It's separated from the rest of the world. Oh, listen, this marvelous light, and if there's a text for us, maybe that's the text, this marvelous light that we live in as Christians, amen. Say, Kevin, I've had a pretty rough week, and I've stumbled and I fell and all these things. I want to tell you this. Listen, you can go to God with that. You can. You can. Listen, when God touches your heart and conviction sets in your heart, praise God, aren't you glad that you can get on your knees and tell God all about it? He already knows all about it, and he's able to help you and forgive you and lift you up and put you on a solid rock. How wonderful it is. And he is that rock, right? As you can read earlier in this scripture here, he's precious unto you, therefore, which believe. He is precious. But in them which be disobedient, the stone which the builders disallowed, the same is made the head of the corner, the stone of stumbling, and a rock of offense, even to them which stumble at the word, being disobedient, whereunto also they were appointed. Amen. 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 But here's what he says, but ye, right? Ain't that great? Ain't there? But ye, listen, you're not like that, right? You're not offended in Jesus Christ. You're not offended in the cross. You're not offended in the blood of the Lamb. Listen, that is your hope. That is your salvation. That is the rock that you stand on, right? Oh, listen, I remember the scripture, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. I want to tell you this. God is still God. He's still above it all. He still owns it all. And praise God, he loves you. Amen. He loves you. Oh, at one time you didn't believe, but now you believe. One time you may have been offended, but now you submit to the holy God. Oh, listen, how gracious he is. Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. Amen. Amen. So he tells us something here that's personal, isn't it? That's real to heart. Listen, that you that have walked with Jesus, you know this to be true, don't you? You can testify of this. But ye are a chosen generation. Amen. Oh, as I was writing some notes down and thinking about these four things that he described us about, listen, this chosen generation. I remember one place, I think it's over in John, where he tells his disciples, you hadn't chosen me, but I have chosen you. Amen. I don't know if you ever think about that, but if you're saved by the grace of God, you've been chosen by God Almighty. Amen. Listen, that he can touch your heart and touch your life and open your eyes and let you know that he's the way. Let you know that he is the light of the world. Amen. How gracious God is and how good he is that he has chosen you. Amen. Oh, listen, I want to tell you this. When you get down and out, when you get discouraged, oh, this is a good scripture to remember, ain't it? Oh, listen, I might not be nothing to this world, right? And I look at myself and sometimes in that way. And I'm not a millionaire, and I don't have a authority or anything like that. I'm just as little as I can be. But you know what? I'm chosen. generation, right? I'm chosen by God. Amen. And you know what? The devil can't do a thing about it. It's grace, isn't it? It's mercy. And that God, listen, I remember a song that knows me the most, loves me the most, right? Knows me best, loves me the most. Listen, he knew what I was when he called me. He knew what I was when he chose me. He knew all these things. But he saved me anyway. He saved me anyway. I'm saved by the grace of God. I'm part of this chosen generation, and you are too. Listen, that we would glorify God. That no matter what Satan says, and no matter what the world says, oh, they may say Christianity, oh, it's not popular. It's not the right way. Well, they're lying. I want to tell you this: it is the right way. It may not be popular to this world, and Jesus may be a stumbling stone to them, but He is precious to us, church. He is precious as us. He has brought us into this marvelous light that we can see that we are a chosen generation. Amen. Listen, that God has touched our hearts. It is God that showed you was lost. It was God that convicted your heart. It was God that gave you the measure of faith. Listen, that you could put your trust in Him. And I've got this hope. I stand in this pulpit and I want to say this, that whosoever will, let him come and drink of the water of life freely, right? Listen, when God has stirred to your heart and moved in your heart, move to Him. Put your trust in Him. Oh, this is a chosen generation. Amen. Right, listen, I think about this and I think about Esther. And how her cousin had told her there, listen, maybe the Lord has put you in this place. Maybe you're in this place for such a time as this. Amen. Listen, we're in this world today, right? We study about Paul, and we think about Peter, and we think about John, and we study about Jesus, and some 2,000 years ago, those the patriarchs of old, and all those that came back. You can go even further back about Moses and Joshua, and all those, and Abraham, and all these. Listen, that pointed to Christ, and then after Christ came, and we look at this, but we're here now, right? In this time, in this age, and we're a chosen generation, right? That we may bring glory to God. To bring glory to God. Oh, listen, I don't have a lot of confidence in a lot of things that I do, right? I'm thankful for the abilities God's gave me. I know they're the grace of God. He's helped me to learn some stuff in my life. It's just amazing to me what He's helped me to do, right? I'm thankful for it, and it's His grace. It's not anything from me, but He helped me to understand a little bit about some things on my job and helped me to get through those things and be able to commission some things and do some, have some understanding and tests and do all these things, and even to this day and the place that I'm in right now, He helps me. I know He does. Before any presentation I go, before any meeting I go to, I pray for God to help me. But I'll tell you this, my confidence isn't in me. My confidence is in the Lord. Say, Kevin, where does that come from? That's through the Holy Spirit of God. Listen, and this knowledge that He has given us, this marvelous light that He has given us to let us know, you're a chosen generation. Kevin, you have been chosen of God, and the devil can't do nothing about it. Amen. How gracious God is, and how wonderful He is. As we look at this royal priesthood, right? And we think, that's what we are now. Did you know that? A lot of this scripture, as we study through the 20th chapter of Revelations and ponder that, my mind went to the scripture that we're a royal priesthood now, right? We're called into a good work, aren't we, right? How wonderful it is that we have this ministry. You can read over in Corinthians about this ministry of reconciliation He has given us. Amen. Right? That we've got the truth to tell to this world. That though you're a sinner, you can be saved. Amen. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow, right? Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool, right? That if you'll believe in Jesus, right, that you can be saved. Though you have come short of the glory of God, we all have, haven't we? We've all sinned and come short. We've got this ministry, right? All this royal priesthood that we can tell a lost and dying world, God still saves.
and the Savior of the world is Jesus, the very Christ, oh, the Savior of the whole world, right? Oh, we talked about His reign, and He reigns in the church, He reigns in our hearts today, but there's going to be a day coming over in Philippians, if you want to read it, that every knee is going to bow, and every tongue is going to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, amen? He is Lord. Oh, but He's Lord in our hearts this very day, isn't He? He's above it all. And He saved us into a good work. Listen, it's not just to sit here and say, I got mine. I don't care about nobody else. That's not what good God puts in your heart. Listen, I know this. I see my wife and observe things. And she's got a deep care for people. She does. And her family. And she wants them to be close to God. And listen, God will stir hearts. And listen, whether they like it or not, she's going to try her best to tell them the truth. She is. Why? Because she loves them. She loves them. And I know the world doesn't want to hear the preacher preach about what morality is, about what's right and what's wrong. But we care, don't we? We care for our neighbors in this community. We care for our friends. We care for our family. We care, and we know you can tell a tree by its fruit, right? Oh, listen, you say, judge not, lest you be judged. That's what the Word of God says. But the Bible does teach us to use judgment, right? And listen, I want to tell you this. When somebody's not doing right, we need to pray for them. We need to tell a lost and dying world. We've got a royal priesthood, amen. I can cry, Abba, Father, listen. Say, Kevin, you ain't nothing royal about you. Oh, I tell you this, how gracious God is, that I'm an heir and a joint heir with who? With Jesus Christ, amen. That's what the Bible tells me. Oh, Kevin, look at you. You're just this old Corrington boy. You don't know nothing. There ain't no royal blood, royalty in your blood at all. Oh, I tell you this, I've been born again. About the grace of God. And I've got this royal priesthood. That's who I am. Amen. That's who the church is. That's who the church is. How gracious God is. Oh, listen, that we can go before the Father. How wonderful it is that we've got an inheritance, don't we? We got an inheritance. Listen, I've got what I got, right? By the grace of God. It's still the grace of God. Say, Kevin, hadn't you worked? Yes. God's been gracious to give me a job. Yes, God's been gracious to where we bought groceries this week. We did. Thank God for it every time. I sit down, and when we sit down and pay the bills, I get so blessed. I get down on my knees, and I think, Lord, you pay my bills for me. You've helped me. You give me this day, this daily bread. Amen. But He's with me. But listen, I want to tell you this. I've got an inheritance over yonder. Oh, listen, Jesus said, I've went and prepared a place for you. Listen, I may not be nothing here, but I'm a child of the King. Amen. His royal blood now flows through my veins. How gracious God is to us that He can open our eyes and let us see in that marvelous light. Oh, I don't know if you've been down this week and you get down because we make mistakes or things are beyond our control. But I want to tell you this. We've got an inheritance in heaven that's better than anything here. Amen. Better than anything here. Oh, I'm going to hurry as we go along here. It says a holy nation, but ye are a holy nation. Amen. A holy nation, separated, sanctified to the work of God. Amen. How wonderful it is. My mind went back over in Isaiah. I think it's somewhere around the 35th chapter, if you ever want to look at that. And it talks about this highway of holiness that we walk on, right? Though we be a wayfaring stranger, he will not err therein. There's no ravenous beasts or anything, but it's a good way. It's a holy way. Listen, we don't talk like the world talks, right? We don't cuss people out. We don't call them names. We show kindness. We show love to one another. Listen, it's different. Listen, we're a holy nation. We're sanctified for God's purpose in our life. Amen? Listen, it's different in our hearts, our lives. Listen, that through the Holy Spirit, I want to tell you this. Everything I tell you today is spiritual. It takes the Holy Spirit to open your eyes. It does. It does. Oh, but this holiness. Oh, listen, I think the Bible says even in the New Testament that He is holy, that we should be holy. Amen. Amen. Oh, listen, He saved us by His grace, hasn't He? He's put us on that solid rock. His Holy Spirit has come in our heart. If you can read over an 8th chapter of Romans, where if we have not the Spirit of God, we're none of His. He's come in our hearts, and He's let us know that we're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. Amen. Listen, that we want to honor God with every deed we do, every word we say, wherever we're at, that we are a child of God. Amen. Holy. His righteousness has come in our heart. Listen, you say, Kevin, do you do good? Oh, listen, the Bible tells me that my righteousness is filthy rags in the sight of God. But He has given me, I'll say it this way, I've heard preachers say it and a theologian say it this way, a foreign righteousness that was beyond me, that He has come into my heart. And His righteousness, the righteousness of Jesus Christ, has been imputed to me. How wonderful that is, right? So if I get up here and preach, if anything good is done, it's through His grace and His power and His might. All this holiness in our heart and life. Listen, I think the church has about forgot about that, don't you? I think we've mingled into so much garbage and so much things that's in this world. We need to know that God has separated us, right? Listen, that He has chosen us, that we're a royal priesthood, and that we're a holy nation, amen, in the midst of a crooked and perverse world, no matter what the presidents say, no matter what the dictators say, no matter what the kings say, we are to trust God. We're to live a life that's pleasing to Him. How gracious, oh, that He is. He has put us into this marvelous life. Let me hurry with this. And we are a peculiar people, right? We're God's people. We're God's people. Oh, that God, that listen, I've heard preachers say it this way. He's not talking about us being odd or anything like that. But we are called by God. We are chosen by God. We're a royal priesthood. We're a holy nation. We are peculiar people. Amen. Listen, that we move with the Holy Spirit of God. I think about God's people there in Israel as they was going through the Hebrew children through the wilderness and how God would guide them, right? And today with the pillar in the cloud and at night with the pillar of fire, right? But when he moved, they would move, right? And listen, church, I want to tell you this. When we're a peculiar people and God tells us to speak, we need to speak. When God tells us to sing, we need to sing. When God tells us to testify, we need to testify. When God tells us to preach, we need to preach. When God tells us to do whatever manner it is, it will be holy, it'll be righteous, it won't be added to this word, and it won't be taken away. Amen? Amen. Oh, this revelation is complete, isn't it? Right? Oh, listen, the Revelation tells us in this way that ought to add to it or the curses will be added to you. And if you take away, your name can be taken away out of the Lamb's book of life, right? How gracious God is, but He's made us a peculiar people, right? A people of God, chosen by God, a chosen generation. A holy, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people. Oh, how gracious He is that He has brought us in this wonderful light. Listen, we don't think like the rest of the world, do we? We don't. We don't. You go down the road and you see somebody in need, your heart goes out to them, don't it? You know, so many times in the world, people think, well, they deserve what they got and all this, but I want to have mercy, don't you? I do. I've had mercy in my life. He has loved me with a great love. And you know what? I want to share that. How about you? It's real to me. It moves me. It touches my heart. I want to be a blessing to you. I know this world, it looks at it, and they don't even believe in God, right? And whatever image they have of God is from their own, is from their own imagination. But I want to tell you, my God is holy. He's righteous. He is just. He is full of mercy and plenteous of grace towards us. And He loves His church, His bride. He died for us, and He rose again. And we are peculiar. Your people, we're separated to the work of God to do what God would have us do. And wherever He sends us, wherever He calls us, we need to go. We need to go. We need to do what God would have us to do. I think about the church and I pray about the missionaries. I go behind, we got that map downstairs and the missionaries' names, and they're around the world. And you know what? We were just a small congregation, but I'm thankful. that this church has a desire to spread the gospel, aren't you? To spread the gospel. I look at some things, and I see some notes there every once in a while, and I see where somebody will make a comment or something that's even watching online here, sees it through the week. And it's from people all around the world, amen, all around the world. And I'm thankful for this church, that we're a people of God. In church, I know you, and you know me. We want to see people saved, don't we? I think about your request. I think about your children. And I think about your grandchildren. I think about all those that don't know the Lord. They need to come to Jesus, right? They need to know about this marvelous life. They need to know that this Savior of the whole world can come in your heart and your life. Listen, it can move you. They can change you. Listen, it's a different walk, isn't it? It's not like the things of the world. Oh, but it's a good way. It's a holy way. It's a righteous way. Oh, and yes, it's separated, sanctified, called by God. God's the one that called me, and the devil can't do anything about it. Amen. Ain't that good news, church? Ain't that good news? Oh, how gracious He is. How wonderful it is to know Jesus, to have Him in your heart and your life. Listen, that ye should shew forth the praises of Him who hath called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. Amen. Amen. How wonderful it is. Oh, His way is it's a right way, isn't it? Oh, when I follow the Lord, I want to tell you this. There is no guilt. There's no shame. Right? You know how the works of the flesh are. There is guilt and shame with the works of the flesh, right? When we get to doing what we want to do instead of what God wants, listen, there's regrets with that, right? There's conviction with that. But I want to tell you what, God's ways is always right. It's always good. It's always holy. We're a separated people from the rest of the world. We're His beloved. Church, listen, we're the church of the living God. Listen, we've been called and touched by God, and His mercy is in our heart and our life. His Holy Spirit has come in our heart. How gracious God is that He would give us that. It's a gift of God, isn't it? It's a gift of God. How wonderful it is. I'm going to close, but I appreciate the Scripture today, and I appreciate what He's put on our heart. I'm thankful for you. Thankful for your prayers. Keep praying for this church. I know God knows what we need. He's able to help us. And I'm thankful for this, that His word is still being preached. Amen. That His word will not return into Him void, but it will accomplish the things in which He intends. Aren't you glad of that? Amen. So now, listen, your labor's not in vain. It isn't, right? But you're going to reap in due season if you faint not. Amen. That's the word of God. How gracious He is. I'm going to pray, and I'm thankful for it. And if somebody's got a need on your heart, something they need to do, you just come on up while we pray. And I'm so thankful for your mercy and His grace. I know He knows the needs of our heart today. Let's pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You again for all that You've done. And we know, dear Jesus, that You're able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think. And Lord, I know, dear Jesus, I'm weak in so many ways. In my verbiage, I'm not a great orator or great with words, dear God, but I know You're able to put Your word in people's hearts. And we thank You, dear God, for these that have come this way, dear God. And we pray, Lord, that You bless them and encourage them. We love You, and we know that You love us. Praise Your holy name today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.